Good morning to everyone. I welcome you and namaste to I welcome you everyone present here on day 4 of the National Level Professional Development Program for Young Law Professional 2020. We have two very dynamic and young resource person of the day, Dr. Vikas Bhati and Dr. Preeti Sharda. Now we have our second panelist of the day, second resource person of the day, Dr. Preeti Sharda. She is librarian at Postgraduate Government College for Girls at Chandigarh. And prior to that institution, she was at Regional Institute of English Chandigarh. She is PhD, UGC NET, and she is having more than 20 years of experience. And she is, instrumental in setting a state-of-the-art RFID system in their library. She is guiding students for PhD and MPhil work. She is also working with Punjab University and IGNU and Algappa University as an academic counselor. She has credit to 20 articles in various reputed journals and edited books. She is a life member of two professional bodies and delivered many invited lectures in library information science field. She is also actively involved in activities of Chandigarh Librarians Association. She is the national advisor to Dr. Ranganathan Society for Social Welfare and Library Development. She is having more than 22 years of experience. She is a blogger, resource manager, and she is expert in automation, library applications, setting up state-of-the-art modern academic library system. She is also running many blogs for their organization. I welcome Dr. Preeti ji for the session. Dr. Preeti?
Am I audible?
Yeah, perfectly you are audible.
And can you see me?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Thank you for the kind words, and first of all, I would congratulate you for organizing this wonderful event. Choices of the topic for the discussion in the program is really, really great. Thank you once again for giving me the topic which I really want to speak on. Friends, without further delay, let's come to the Google Classroom for using it for online learning and teaching. I was introduced to Google Classroom in the year 2018 in some JUSA sponsored program. Since then, it is part of my library, and as well as for my institution, I am using the Google Classroom. What we actually do, we make one classroom for each course, and teachers and me are part of that classroom. I share library resources and teachers share their classroom work. Now the question arises, what is Google Classroom? Google Classroom is a free educational software. It is provided us by the Google, and it enables educationists, including teachers, librarians, and students, and the students to go paperless. Offered by Google as a free service for educational institution and just about anybody with a personal Google account, that's a must. We should have a personal Google account to have access to Google Classroom. This program makes easier to the instructors as well as the students to connect each other even outside the campus. The app is available for both PC and mobile, so you can use whichever device to access your account and start working for your lessons. Google Classroom is no doubt a convenient platform for both teachers and students. Though through its guardian features, even which is available with the G Suite account, even the parents can keep track of their wards, and they can know what their students are doing and what are their grades and whether they are completing their assignments or not. In a way, it helps them to keep a check on their child. Everything whatever we do in the Google Classroom is being saved in the Google Drive. So in a way, it is a secure system paperless system and a wonderful system. Let me share my PPT. Am I allowed to share PPT, Dr. Manish? Hello?
Please share your PPT.
Okay. Just a second.
Did you share it?
Just a second, I'm just working on it.
Okay.
Can you see it now?
It's taking a bit time, but I think it will be in a few seconds.
I'm in the librarian. Can you see now, it?
Yeah, now you can. Yes, it is now. It is
okay.
Now.
Okay. Being a librarian, I'm using Google Classroom for providing orientation program and literacy services and supplying material to my students. And my teachers are using it for other purposes, like they are teaching, they are making videos, they are uploading the videos on YouTube, they are sharing the links to the Google Classroom, they provide PPTs to the students, they provide other learning material to the students. Students read the material, go through the videos, and come to the forum of Google Classroom and discuss the problems with the teachers. Teachers also give the assignment to the Google Classroom. Students do the assignment, complete the assignment, and send it back through the Google Classroom. Teacher checks the assignment to the Google Classroom and assign the numbers and grades and send them back to the teacher. After sending the grade to the student, a grade card is also being recorded and it can be downloaded in a CSV format. So in a way, it's a complete package. It's a complete learning platform which can be used by students and teachers. In my session, I'll be talking about what is Google Classroom, how to get access to it, and what are its various features. And I'll just try to demonstrate the features through the demo of Google Classroom. It's a free web-based service which is provided by the Google, as I earlier told you. And it is simply used for creating, distributing, and grading the assignments. The primary purpose of Google is streamlining the process of sharing the material between the students and the teachers. It helps to retain the material as whatever we do in the classroom is being saved in our Google Drives with the name of the folder called Classroom. And in the classroom, individual class folder is being created. I'll show you that also. So whenever I want to repeat the material, I want to give the material back to the student, I just click on my Google Drive and add the material to the classroom. I don't have to upload again and again. Once uploaded in the Google Classroom, it can be used by the students. This is the mission of Google Classroom, which is given by the Google itself. Mission control for your classroom. This is the tagline given to the Google Classroom. It was developed by the Google and it was launched in August 2000. It is just a little bit of history about Google Classroom. It was launched in August 2014, but the restriction was that it was only people with the G Suite account for education program can use it. I just want to add one thing here. G Suite for education is free. We all educational institutions can just enroll ourselves for this program. This is provided free of cost by the Google. It's a myth that it is being paid program. No, it is not. It is paid program. It can be used by any of the educational institutions. They provide us free of cost. In 2017, what Google did, it made Google Classroom free And anyone, maybe I'm not having my G Suite account, anyone with a Gmail address can use this platform. In August 2018, it made major changes, and major changes were made in the classroom section of the Google Classroom. Since then, it is being used by many, many teachers, and this lockdown period has enhanced the use of Google Classroom. The beauty of this product is that it is being regularly operated. Like in April 2020, Google Meet was included in Google Classroom, incorporated in Google Classroom. Prior to this, rubric system was included in Google Classroom. In a way, they are regularly updating it. And I would say that about 100 million people, 100 million teachers are using Google Classroom. This data is of March 2020. And Google says that about 100 million teachers are using Google Classroom worldwide for sending their assignments and to communicate with the student. And I think this data, maybe in 2 months' time, it must have been enhanced. Why to use Google Classroom? It's very, very easy to learn. If you just invest 1 hour of time with Google Classroom, you can learn it. No definite training is required for that. No risk, it is safe, because whenever you download a Google Classroom app in your phone or a tab, it never asks for any permission. There are no ads in it. It's pretty safe because our data is not saved on their server. The data is being saved in our server, that's on Google Drive. It's a digital organizer because it incorporates most of the Google apps, like Google Calendar, Google Sheet, Google, about 70 apps are being incorporated in. So whatever we do in the Google Classroom, we can just add on Google apps like Google Sheet, Google Slide, Google Doc, Google Calendar, Google Drive, everything is being organized in the Google Classroom, and teachers and students can get track of the classwork and assignments through the Google Calendar. Just like whenever we have a Zoom meeting or Cisco meeting, we just add our things to the Google Calendar. Here, the Google Calendar is automatically incorporated. All paperless, from enrolling the student to the marking of system and to the grade card, everything is paperless. No paperwork is required in the Google Classroom. Sending the assignment, checking the assignment, everything is done paperless. It's flexible because teacher has all the rights. Teachers can add a student, teacher can add whatever material they want, teacher can delete a student, teacher can upgrade a student, teacher can add a teacher. In a way, it's a very, very, very flexible. You can change any, you can change the settings of Classroom at any point of time. And as I was told, it is incorporate most of the Google apps, plus apps like Quizlet and other popular apps can also be integrated in Google Classroom. So it's very flexible. So what are the benefits of Google Classroom? First is flip of the classroom. As I earlier said, material, video lectures, PPTs, everything is given to the student freehand. Students see the video lectures, read the PPT, whatever problems they have, come with the problem with the Google Classroom stream section. They pose their question and teacher answers the question. It is like teacher preparing the material, giving to the student reading the material, coming to the student, and teacher and student interact at the stream. It's a kind of flipped classroom. Otherwise, in the classroom teaching, first of all, teacher teaches to the student, and then teacher go and read, and then they come to the class. In this class setup, student read first, then come to the teacher for the problem. Everything is being saved in Google Drive, that I've already told. Interaction is very well possible. It's the stream of Google Classroom. I will show you the stream also. The stream of Google Classroom is just like a chat box. you can send whatever material you want, maybe a PPT or a video or some file, something from the Google Drive. And even the students can interact with each other, interact with the teachers in the stream section. Collaboration is very well possible, because if I want a group work, if I want my student to create a PPT, I can create a Google slide and just send to my student, the group of students I want to work together. They will coordinate with each other, work with each other, and give me the slide again on the Google Classroom platform. It saves the time, because I can just create the material, I can save the material on my Google Drive, I can just, in one click, I can just send the material to each class. Suppose tomorrow is the holiday for the college or the school. What we already do, always do, we put on the notice board, we on every WhatsApp group, we send the message. And on this platform, we just create a message. In one click, I can send to n number of students. In one class, there can be 100 students, and there is no limit of classes. You can have 1,000 classes. In a way, you can send 100 into 1,000 students in one click. Your message will go to 1 million students in one click. Whenever students reply, whenever students give the assignment back to the teachers, teachers can check the assignment here only. They can give the feedback, they can write notes on it, and they can grade the assignments and send them back to the student. In a way, each student can see what are the problems. They don't have to wait for teachers, because teachers don't have to do much. Jaise, whenever the sheet is created, they can check it and grade it automatically. Totals are done automatically, and even the rubric system is incorporated. The students can get to know whether the problem is in the content or in the language or in the grammar. They can just know it. Basically, what are the features? I'll just show you the screenshot of Google Classroom. This is the way Google Classroom looks. This is stream. This is stream. This is classwork. This is people, and this is marks. And this is the setting button. Stream. Let's just talk about a bit on all these, and then I'll show you the demo of Google Classroom. We talked about all these four people. Is just adding the teachers as well as the students. We can add the teachers through invite. We can send invite. We can send an invite mail to the teachers, and teachers can just accept it and be the member of our class. And students can be added in two ways. First is, we can give them the class code. How class code is generated, I will tell you. And the email. We can just send an invite through email to the students, and they can just accept it and be a member of Google Classroom. Stream, as I told you, it is for the announcement. It is for the conversation. It is like a conversational help. It is a chat box. It is just like a WhatsApp. Classwork, it is heart of the Google Classroom. Teachers provide assignments, quiz material to the students, and students send back the assignment to the teachers and get the grades. And marks is just like a mark sheet of a class as well as a student. This is the screenshot of the Google Classroom. And here is the setting button. This is the setting button. Let me tell you something about the setting button. In setting button, we can add class details, name, section, room, and subject. Only the class theme is mandatory. Other things, if we want to add, we can add. If we don't want to add, we don't. In the setting button, the next marking system. We want to add rubric or not. We should have the overall mark sheet, or we should have the weightage. whatever we want to decide about the marks, we have to decide in the setting button only. If we want to change the class code, it is being done in the setting button only. And if you want to disable, if you find that some students are entering the class without your permission through the class code, you can disable the class code or you can reset the class code. Here in settings, you can give privileges to the students also, whether they can communicate with us or not, whether they can share our files or not, whether they can only, whether the teachers can only share. These all privileges are given in the setting buttons only. Let's sum up like this. What teachers can do, teachers can create and manage the classes, share the resources. They can give real-time feedback and grades. What students can do, they can track the classwork and material. They can share resources and interact with their teachers and their peers. And they can submit assignment and get feedback and grades. If I talk about the stream, in stream, we can make announcement, we can facilitate the interaction between peers, teachers, students. We can add material from the Google Drive and devices, other devices. We can provide links. We can upload the YouTube video. It's a virtual forum. Suppose if I want to have a discussion on a book or I want to have a discussion on a topic, I can create in the stream only. And whenever a classwork is created, whenever an assignment is given, it is being announced in the stream button of the Google Classroom. So if we'll work on the Google Classroom, we can do four things in the Google Classroom. Google Classwork, we can do four things. We can send assignments, we can send quiz assignment, we can send question, and we can add material. These are the steps to get into the classroom. We can create a classroom, we can create a classwork. Creating the classroom means giving a name and a design to the classroom. Creating a classwork means creating an assignment for the student. Sending the assignment is assigning the classwork. And receiving back the assignments and grading the assignment is grading the assignment. So let's start it. If you want to log in, it is through classroom.google.com. And if you want to download the app, it's available in the Play Store or iOS on the iOS also. You can just download it. Let me share my Google Classroom with you. Can you see my Google Classroom? Dr. Manish, can you see my Google Classroom?
No, it is not actually. It is the searching, I think.
It is saying you are sharing your screen.
Yeah, you share it.
Is it okay? You can see that? My Google Classroom?
Yeah, right now, yes. Now it is.
Okay. This is my Google Classroom. Okay. I have so many classes in my Google Classroom. I've created so much classes, and half of the classes are archive also. I'll tell you how to archive and what is the use of archive also. Let's do one by one. First of all, you can when you want to get into the classroom, just type Google Classroom in the Chrome or whatever browser you're using. You just enter your email address, Gmail address actually, and the password, you will get into the classroom. And this will be the screenshot. Actually, I have so many classes, yours will be the empty. So this is the, these are the classroom. If this is the plus button over here, you can join a class or you can create a class. If your teacher has invited you through the class code, you can join the class from here. I'll show you the student version also. First of all, let me create a class for you. This is creating a class. This will ask for terms and condition. I had just click on yes and we can continue. Here it will ask what is your classroom name. So let's do it, Preeti Sharda. This is my class right now and I'll create a class. It may take few seconds to create a class. This class is created. By default, this is a picture of my class. This is stream, this is classwork, this is people, this is marks, and this is the setting button. And these all Google apps are being incorporated with the Google Classroom. Okay. I'll just add one Google Classroom of my student also. This is the way your screen may appear. I have already made three classes for my student. This is my class and this is my student view. I'm showing you a teacher's view and a student view. I have created one class that is called Preeti Sharda class. I want to invite a student in it. Here is a class code for it. This is a class code for my class. I can just copy.
Preeti ji, your class is not showing.
What happened? Actually, can you see me right now?
Right now I can see that.
Which class you can see, sir?
Now it is now. I think you made some changes.
No, no, sir, it's my student class which you are seeing. Can you see my class? This is my class.
Actually,
this is my class.
Okay. Right now it is Google search.
No, it okay, it may take time. This is Google Classroom. Can you see it? Which problem is there?
Now,
this is my class.
Yes.
This is my class. Okay. This is my class. If I want to add student to my class, I can just click on this class code. I just copy the class code. This is the student's view. This is student class. I can just click on join class. Enter the class code and make him join the class. Now, this is Preeti Sharda class. This is student's view and this is teacher's view. Actually, I think this is teacher's view. And what is the difference between student's view and teacher's view is, first, teacher's view has stream, classwork, people, marks, and settings. You can see that? Stream, classwork, people, marks, and settings also. But if I switch to the student's view, it has stream, classwork, people, no setting button. No marks button and no setting button. This is the difference between student's view and the teacher's view. Let's talk about the sections one by one. This is a stream button. I told you this is like a chat box. I can say anything to my class. I can say hi to my class. I can add anything to my class, like I can add something from Google Drive, I can add some link, I can add some file, I can have a YouTube video. Whatever teachers want, they can add from here. Suppose if I want to add a file from my PC, I can just click on it. Select a file. Open and upload. This is a way the file is being added. Okay, and now I can send any of the classes. If I want to send all, I can send this material to all my classes. If I want to stick on my class, I can stick. In this way, I can send my file to all. I told you, I can just send one file to all my classes. If I want to stick, I can select the student. There is only one student right now. Otherwise, I can select the student also. I can be selective in the student also. I can post it right now. I can schedule it right now. I mean to say, I want to send it 5 days back, after 5 days or 10 days. Or if I don't have the date of sending this assignment, I can just save it. Whenever I want to send it, I can send it from there. This is the way I can send material to my students. And I'll just click on post. The material is being posted. It says like this. This is teacher's view. I'll show you the student's view also. This is student's view. If I refresh it, the material has been posted to the student group. In this way, I can send material to my students anytime. Again, I'm going to my teacher's view. I have classwork over here, which is heart of classroom, Google Classroom. In this, I can make an assignment. I can send a quiz assignment. I can pose a question. I can send a material. I can arrange my material in accordance with the topic I have. Assignment means sending something handy to the students. Maybe some subjective questions I want to ask from the students. I can just click on it. I can write a piece, tell me something about Google Classroom. I can give instruction over like 500 words. Here I can add two things. First thing is point, how much marks it covers. It's for 10 marks or 15 marks or 20 marks. Okay, I say it's for 20 marks. Okay, or I can say I can leave it 100 marks. One beautiful thing added over here recently is rule. If I want that my student should know what is the problem, what are the good things of the essay, I just create a rubric over here. It is the rubric platform of Google Classroom. Criteria first is content, how the content is. What is the student's content? If I say criterion description, I can add it. The point is one, point is three, level is three, and description, very good. If the content is very good, I can say I can give them 3 marks. I can add the rubric over here. I can say two, level is two, and it's good. I can again add a rubric. point is one, level is one, and the content is poor. I can save the rubric overlay. I have to, how will teach students give answer to me? I'll create a Google Doc over here. The Google Doc is created, and I can give the title to it. Any title you want to give. And I can just close it. Okay, the assignment is the word, the doc file is created, the rubric is written. Now, if I want to assign this to my student, I can just send it. Now I can view also, I can edit also. If I want to edit it, I can edit it. As I didn't give the deadline, I will edit it and give the due date also. I can give the due date like 15 and time is 12 p.m. So the time is also added to my, now I can just again save it. This is my assignment. The assignment is created and let's see the student's view. This is the student's view. You can see an assignment over here. They've got an assignment. I just click on the assignment. As a student, I can write the answer. I don't know why it's not like.
Yeah, voice is there. You can continue.
And you can hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. The student teacher can student can write anything to it. This is the document which I created. Okay. I'll tell you what students have to do. Students have to add a create. I don't know why typing is not on keyboard. I don't know, keyboard is not working. Anyways, when student answers this, and he can say, mark it's done. When the student send his mark it's done, it is again returned to the student. Okay. My class, I can see the classwork and I can find that one student has handed over. First it was assigned, now it's handed over. I can just click on it. I can see the document and I can give the marks away. I can give maybe I'm giving 100 marks, 100 of the 100, and just return it. In this way, I have checked the assignment and returned it back to the students. And the students can also see that they have got the marks for their assignment. So in a way, I have assigned assignment. Students completed the assignment and I have given the marks to them. Again, this is my class. I've told you how to use the stream. I've told you how to use the classwork. In classwork, we can add a Google form over here. If you want to send a Google form to your student, you can just click on quiz. The title is feedback. Anything you want to write. You can add a question, whatever you want to say, your name and whatever you want to say in your Google form. You can change the name also here. Okay, this thing is automatically saved. You can go again to your classroom. Actually, this is pretty slow. I can see in my another desktop, it's pretty slow. Okay, if I go back to my classroom work, then this is being created. And students can reply to it. The feedback is there. It's not, I have not sent it. This is edited and you can assign it. Let me take you to the student's view. And they have got a new assignment over. They can just click on it. They can fill the form and then just mark is done. Once they, I can just fill the form. I can submit it over here. I can go and just mark it as done. Once this step is very, very important till the time you don't do mark is done, it will not be sent in your classroom. So one here, this is one assigned, but I have to refresh it. And now I can see it is one handed. This is the feedback. I can see one has handed it, means one has returned. I can just open it. I can give the marks, whatever marks I want to give. I can check it over here. I can give the marks and I have to return. This step is very, very important. Till the time I don't return the quiz or assignment to the student, it won't be added in the mark sheet. I will like to show you the mark sheet, how mark sheet created. I'll just send it return. Okay. This is again, I can go to my class. This is my class. And I'll show you how can I create a mark sheet. This is mark section. This will tell you that this is my student. I gave him 2 assignments and he has scored 100 marks out of 100. So if I want to get the mark sheet on it, I'll have to go to the classwork and open it. and I can just download all the marks CSV file. If I do this, it will ask me where to save. I can say desktop. And the CSV file, I mean to say the marksheet is being created. This is a new feature of Google Classroom. Earlier, this feature was not added. The grades feature, the marks feature was not there in the Google Classroom. So this is my marksheet. My student got two, I gave two assignments to my student. In both of the assignments, it got 100. Can you see it? Okay, let's go to the classroom again. I've told you about the stream feature, the classwork feature, the people. Okay, let me tell something about the people. If I want to invite any teacher in it, I can just add and just write the email. Maybe okay, this is, and I can just send the invite. In this way, the invite has gone to the teacher. The only way to make teacher join the classroom is just sending the invite. For students, we can do it two ways. First is by sending an email and by giving the classroom. Students can join a class by class code also, and the teacher can send the invite. I've told you the stream, classwork, people, and marks, all the four features of Google Classroom. I just share one more feature, that is this. This tells about all the classes. This is the Google Calendar. Can you see it? Google Calendar. This is the Google Calendar. These are all my active classes. And these are classes made by me. These are all classes which are made by me. And these two classes are classes in which I am a member. I am a student. And when I click on the archive classes, these are the classes which I have archived. Archiving means the material of the class is there only. Student can see the materials, they can see the discussion. One thing will be stopped, that is interaction. There will be no sharing, there will be no interaction after we archive the class. But there is a special provision over here in which you can either restore the class or permanently delete the class. Restoring the class means making the class active again, and deleting the class means that delete everything, whatever material, whatever interaction, whatever things I have in my class. If I restore it, it will go to the main classes. If I want to archive this class also, I can just, the class which I created right now, if I want to archive this class, I'll have to go here and just archive it here. If I archive it, it will ask, shall I archive it? And when I click on it, and this class is not here. If I want to restore it again, I have to go to the archive session. I have to restore the class again. We'll ask the permission and I will restore the class. I can see my class. Okay. This is there. Okay. One more thing is changing the theme. If you don't like this theme, you can select another theme. You can change the theme. Whatever themes you want, they are available in accordance to your preferences. You can select the theme. Whatever theme you want. And the themes will be changes. Even you can upload your photo from here. If you want to change this theme, you can upload the classroom photo for your college photo, your classroom photo, you can upload here. And this is the setting button, which has the details of my class. This is the class code. This is the class code, and you can give permission. Only students can comment. Students can post and comment. Only teachers can comment. These are the privileges which you can use in the stream. Okay, so you can reset the class code also. You can disable the class code also. Reset means changing the class code. You can't have a class code of your choice. Whatever Google is providing, you can use those class codes only. And you can disable the class code. You don't want more students to be added in the classroom. You can disable the class code. These are the marks. So if you want the overall marks, you can have the total points. You can have the weightage category. You can add category. Suppose if you want to have quizzes, regular assignment, you can add the category over here. Like I want to add a category essay. I want to assign essay marks 10. I can again add an entry. If it is quiz, marks is 10. So I can add the category like this. Adding a category and just save it. So this is all about Google Classroom. These are the apps which you can add in the Google Classroom. This is settings. This is marks, people, classroom, and this is Google Calendar. I think Manishji, I have covered all the topics.
Thank you, Preeti ji. You have covered each and every aspect of the Google Classroom and how can it be used. We have with us Professor M.K. Sinha sir from Assam. Okay. And he had a question that how we can use the Google Classroom for long answers and questions.
Sir, I told you the assignment was there. In the assignment only, shall I show you? You can use Google Sheet. I told you how to use Google Sheet. Suppose a Google Classroom, and this is the assignment over here. You can write question like tell the history of UGC. Okay, you can create a Google Doc over here. a Google Doc will be created. Okay, and if I again go to the Google Classroom, every student can have its own copy. In this way, we can make a copy for each student. A Google Doc is being created and it can be of 2000 words. And I can assign it. Whenever a student writes, he can. So the long question is very well done. For the objective questions, we can use Google Form. Questions, we can use Google Doc. And we can assign this. Is it fine? I can't hear.
One more question from Ms. Mukta ji. Can a teacher make account on Google Classroom? I think you have already covered it.
It's your Gmail which allows you. Don't have to make new account. It's Gmail. Just enter with your Gmail pass. Just enter your Google Classroom.
Yeah. One question from Mr. Narendra Pal ji. He is asking that how many participants can participate at a time using Google Classroom?
In one classroom, the limit is 100.
Okay, and another question is, what are the limitations of the Google Classroom?
Only limitation is that we can't go live like Zoom and EPS. Google Meet is being incorporated, but it is with the student account only. Otherwise, I don't find any limitation in the Google Classroom.
Okay.